When are we getting the apartment downstairs so we can have a studio again?
I think we're live.
Yes.
I think we're live. Say, I think we're live. Yes. I see us on the thing. I think
yes.
What happened is, so Biohazard logged into my account, changed what server I connect to, and that's what did it. So this is, you're not off the hook, Biohazard. This is what, still on you.
What server were you connecting to?
I don't feel like I want to say that it wasn't Asia. Lesson learned. Don't try to connect to an Asian server when streaming not from Asia.
That's true.
I don't know why I was connected to that.
It'll mess up the internet in the entire household.
Yeah. I mean, now everything's fine. Yeah. Well, yeah, our ping was like over like 900.
Yeah, it was over 9,000. We're so popular now that I made that joke.
Yeah. So anyway, now that the show has gone,
where did we leave off? What's the last thing the viewers heard?
You were talking about Minecraft.
Yeah, I don't want to wait a minute for the response.
You were talking about Minecraft and how.
Okay.
I have not been playing it.
Been playing a ton of Minecraft. You've not been playing a ton of Minecraft. I've been thinking about looking at Terraria again. I don't know if I will, though. I do know I'm going to announce here officially, so I have to...
What?
Yeah, I'm going to make an official announcement. Once the Feed the Beast 1710 mod packs come out, I will be doing a Let's Play from, like, Scrap that mod pack.
That's a bold statement.
Yeah, it is.
Folks, I will not be a part of this Let's Play.
It'll be weekly. Kyle will be there. It'll be FrameLoss Minecraft. We'll be doing it every week. Or
I didn't
so,
sign up for that.
But it's a solid amount of time off. Those mod packs are not close to done yet. So
right. Well, I look forward to weaseling my way out of that.
False. What have you been playing?
I've been playing a bunch of Street Fighter.
Are you a fish?
I've been playing. I played a little smidgen of Minecraft, and I also have resubbed to a World of Warcraft.
Woo!
Everyone at work, let's say two people at work were talking about it, and I really, really got excited, and I wanted to play it, so I jumped back in about 2 days ago, and I've been going pretty hard at that.
I'm so happy to have you back. I'm not there yet.
Yeah,
but
you're not even subbed.
I mean, I will be. It's probably a tonight. Given that I'm the one that usually
caves
induces this in the first place. So
no, Brandon is the one who usually
no. Brandon's Space Camp. He can't play Minecraft.
Right. Well, he is playing Minecraft. He's not playing WoW.
I mean, WoW. Yeah.
Guys, you can boo all you want. I know what I'm doing is wrong in the inside. But
World of Warcraft.
I have to keep going. I also have been playing another game that we will talk about at the end of the show because I have an announcement to make. But we'll save that for later, just for you people.
I'm so excited. What could it be?
Oh, God. Fish Plays WoW.
Oh, Fish Plays WoW would be amazing.
Unwatchable.
Yeah. What about Girlfriend Plays WoW and I just stream Monique?
Yeah. I mean, that would get views.
Yeah. That would go well.
That's pretty much what I've been playing. Street Fighter, Minecraft, WoW, and this other game that I'm really excited to talk about later.
Nice. Well, 3 out of 4 of those sound really good.
I feel you know what the secret game is, and that makes it even better.
Can I know this isn't on our thing anywhere, but I just need to talk about this game and how badly I want to play it. It's Hatoful Boyfriend. Hatoful Boyfriend.
The one where you take care of the duck?
No, almost. It's you are accepted as the only human student at St. Pigeon Nations Institute.
Oh, the pigeon. Yeah, okay, yep.
It's a pigeon dating sim.
Yeah, I know what you're talking
about. I want to play it so bad, and I'm not going to pay $9 to pre-order it.
Dude, you got to jump on that.
If someone wanted to buy it for me, I would probably Let's Play. I would not probably Let's Play it. If someone bought it for me, I would 100% Let's Play it. That would be the deal, but I couldn't be more interested in this game for like the silliest reasons. The collector's edition is called the Summer of Dove collector's edition. what in the world?
Okay. It's not okay.
It's amazing. I want to play it so bad.
Okay.
So I had to talk about that because I had to get my excitement out about it.
Well, take us into releases of the week, because there really isn't much to talk about there.
Yeah, there's not too much. Releases of the week. First up, we got Tales of Xillia 2 for the PS3. Just a generic JRPG, in my opinion. I mean, I've seen a lot about it, but, you know, it is what it is.
Yeah.
It's just yet another anime RPG.
It doesn't look the greatest.
Yeah. If you like the Tales series...
I heard the Tales of Xillia 1 game... like was kind of a letdown, so
yeah, I would agree. I would agree.
Even say if you like Tales of Xillia.
No, I would say if you like the Tales series.
No, because my girlfriend loves the Tales series and she hates that game.
I was gonna say give it a shot, which she did. She obviously tried.
Give it a shot, yeah.
So yeah, it's I would give it a pass until it's like $10 at GameStop, then maybe try it.
Yeah. But
other than that, we have Diablo Reaper of Souls on the Xbox One, the PS4, the PS3, and the Xbox 360. This is the Diablo expansion pack that was released last year for PS3. Was it even last year? Might have just been in March.
I think it was this year.
Okay, yeah, so I think it was in March then. March for the PC. It plays really nicely on consoles from everything
I've
seen.
Yeah, it really does.
I would do it. I'd play it, I think. I haven't played it on the PC at all. I haven't made the $30 commitment to...
Yeah, you don't even have the PC one.
I know, but that's all the more reason for me to play it on a console, right?
Yeah.
It looks fun. The menus have been updated from the original Diablo 3 release. The controls have been updated a little bit. So it got like the spit shine it needed. And in addition to that, you know, you get... the Crusader class, the Act 5, Act 5,
yeah.
The Rifts, all that fun stuff, so.
Yeah.
That's what we got for releases of the week.
So, we kind of dropped the Trailers of the Week segment because it just kind of felt weird, because we usually talk about them in length, so we just added it to News of the Week. So, we're just going to jump right into that, and we're going to start with a new game that they showed at Gamescom 2 weeks ago. Actually, I think this one was shown, like, the other day.
Yeah, this is pretty new.
Yeah, the game is called Torin. I think the art style is beautiful. I don't know a lot about the game, but it looks great. Let's just jump right into that trailer. Here we go. So that's Torin. I love the artwork. Everything about it reminds me very much of, like, Ico or Shadow of the Colossus, Last Guardian, anything that team's put out.
Yeah, you definitely get that alone vibe.
Yeah.
That is special. I would say, as far as that game looks, it looks like it'll be a lot of fun. As far as how that game looks, it looks like a cross between, like, Maximo and a Myst cinematic, so I'm not really impressed with the graphics.
See, I think the graphics are very stylized, and I really like them.
Stylized is one thing, but, like, it literally looks like they took files from Myst.
We'll see. I think we did see that. I think it looks good.
I think it'll be fun. I think it'll be a lot of fun.
Yeah. It looks like a really good adventure.
I like that it's inspired by The Last Guardian.
Yeah.
Video games are just inspired by other video games now.
Yep. So next we have Biohazard. I don't want to hear you're so sass. Next we have a DLC trailer. Yeah. I mean,
next we have a waste of your next 2 minutes.
Yeah. I think it looks good. So that's why I picked it. I'm the host of the show. I can do that. I'm excited for the DLC, and since I bought the season pass for this game, I have to be excited for it because I already paid for this stupid thing. So here's the Trials. I already forgot what the DLC is called.
Trials Fusion Empire of the Sky.
Empire of the Sky. Here's that.
PEGI 12.
So that's the new expansion, DLC, whatever you want to call it. It's out now, so if you bought the season pass, go play it, because Trials is really fun.
Wait, did we even talk about Riders of the Rustlands, the first one?
No. There were probably more important things to talk about.
I was going to say, we were too big time to talk about.
This is how good of a news week this is.
Oh, man. Well, I mean, it looks fun. It's Trials.
Yeah, I like
Trials has always been Trials. I feel like I'm not the creative type of person that really gets the most out of Trials because half of that game is making your own levels. And
like,
yeah,
a couch.
I would not have thought of turning that couch. I'll tell you that much.
Yeah. New objects.
I feel like that's one of those games where half of it is building your own stuff, which is just not my thing. So I don't love them, but I'm sure that I love the other side of the Trials games. I like playing the tracks. So
yeah,
it looks good. Looks fun. For like 99 cents, that's a steal.
Here it is. The secret Wii U trailer.
Oh, man. Get hype. Get hype. Stay hype.
This trailer, I'm going to preface it with, this is the reason right now everyone should be pumped to buy a Wii U. I think CJ already knows what it is just because of how excited I am about talking about this trailer.
Yeah, I know what it is.
What do you think it is?
Bayonetta 2.
Let's go into the trailer and get hype. Secret Wii U trailer. This is why you're buying a Wii U this holiday. Dude, dolphin up.
So
get excited.
My feedback about this game is that I have 100 1,000,000% played this Flash game before. And I'm not saying that as like a snide comment, like, I've played that Flash game. I've literally played that Flash game before.
Now, have you played Echo the Dolphin?
Yes.
Okay. So yeah, remember when the Wii U was like, hey, we're going to be different than the Wii? They're not.
Nope, not even a little bit. It's so upsetting for me to have seen that video. Okay, also, I think the other thing I should say is that I played that Flash game so long ago that I can't tell you, like, where I played it, where, website or location, physical. I can't tell you how old I was. I can't really tell you much beyond the fact that 100%, like, I've played that game. All you do is you do flips and spins, and you do a tail slide across the water.
And sometimes you're
you
in
go
Orca.
Up space. You go, you get that like space thing, star slides. I don't know the Orca.
You haven't explained though about the Orca.
The Orca is new. There wasn't an Orca when I played, so that's probably why it's a game now.
It's remastered.
Yeah, I mean that checks out considering that it was a Flash game. I should hope so, is my response.
I was really excited when I saw that trailer because I was like, oh, man, we don't talk about the Wii U enough. We should give the Wii U its moment in the sun.
This is why we can't have nice things. The Wii U, I can't even talk about it. It's so upsetting. The Wii U should have been so much better than what Nintendo is doing to it.
Yeah. I mean, it still has, I'm not going to say the Wii U's like, I'm done with it yet. I liked Mario Kart. I'm really hyped for Bayonetta, but
dude, you can't come out with a game a year and be like, "Yeah, we're a legitimate console."
I mean, they supposedly have a couple this holiday.
Yeah, supposedly they have Smash Bros, which is that's it.
I saw someone mention Hyrule Warriors in the chat, and I could give two shits about Hyrule Warriors. I don't want Dynasty Warriors 1 from the PlayStation 1 with Nintendo characters.
Yeah, you do. Hyrule Warriors is going to be pretty sweet.
No, I'm not on that game's bandwagon.
That's because you only like that.
I played Dynasty Warriors before, okay?
Right, this is Nintendo Dynasty Warriors, though. This is, again, this is the newest thing Dynasty Warriors has done in years.
Maybe 3 years.
When did Gundam come out? More than 3 years ago.
Maybe.
Because they came out with two already.
But who cares? It's the same
game as
Gundam, just with Nintendo characters.
2007. So 7 years. This is the newest thing they've done in seven years.
Wasn't there Dynasty Warriors Gundam 2?
Right, but that's not new. That's a sequel.
Okay. But that's still a sequel, just Dynasty Warriors. What I'm saying is this isn't new. It's just a reskinned Dynasty Warriors.
You don't know that. There's, like, magic in this one.
There's magic in Dynasty Warriors.
This has Dekus. Deku Dekus.
Okay. You got me there.
I'm just saying, man.
Whatever.
I'm just saying. I'll do a Let's Play for Dolphin Up. Okay. I'll do a Let's Play for everything.
Moving on. Let's talk about another company that's doing really well right now.
Speaking of doing well.
A tweet went out stating that The Sims 4 will not be given to press early and to expect reviews coming out after the game is launched. So that brings up a lot of red flags. Because anytime that happens, that's never a good sign.
That has literally never been good for a game. Not once in the entire 30, 40, 50 year history of video gaming has that been a good thing.
Holding review copies and being like, well, just wait till it's released, doesn't bode well. That means they're trying to hit the initial sales, and then everything after that...
It'll just be a
slippery slope of bad reviews. And from what I've heard, a lot of the people who got hands-on with it already were saying it's missing a ton of features. There was an article I read where there were like 89 things missing from this Sims game that were in the last one.
Aren't there no pools?
Yeah, there's no pools.
Which has like been a staple of the Sims, is you put them in the pool and then you get rid of the ladder.
You can't really walk around the map like you could in Sims 3. There's no more, like, babies are just, like, a thing now. They don't, like, you don't have to take care of them. They just, like,
they just take care of themselves.
Yeah, they're just baby, and then, boom, they're, like, a kid.
That's what I want, is babies that act like adults. That's my dream come true. Grown-up babies.
Yeah.
Let me be clear. I don't want grown-up babies. Please don't Google grown-up babies. Do nothing with that phrase.
Yeah, so I don't see The Sims 4 doing very well. Because Sims fans are pretty fickle.
Yeah, I mean,
I live with one, and she is not happy about the current situation of Simland.
I don't know how you devance. I don't know what the word opposite of it. Retreat your series. That doesn't sound right.
No,
like go back. They're going back. They're taking things away.
Yeah, I don't understand it.
It's just not a bad. It's not a good model. I don't know why they think it's going to work, but.
Yeah, I don't have the list on me right now, but yeah, it was. I think the list was called 89 Things Missing from The Sims 4.
I will have to Google that after the show and read them aloud for everyone. A dramatic reading.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, well, on the opposite side of the coin, that's a bad PC game. Let's talk about a good PC game. Wasteland 2 got an official release date. September 19th is the release date. 20 years it took us to get from Wasteland to Wasteland 2. I think it's going to be amazing for fans of the series. Not just fans of Wasteland, but fans of Fallout and stuff. Anyone who's been following the project knows that it's a spiritual sequel to Fallout 2 and Fallout 1, I guess, in theory. But it's the same people that worked on... Or some of the same people, rather, that worked on the Fallout games doing their magic with Wasteland. I've seen a lot of videos. I've seen a lot of feedback. The game looks amazing. The game sounds like it plays amazing. I can't wait to try it.
Yeah, I'm really excited for this. I just wish that it wasn't coming out when it is. Because we're going to go over this next episode. We're going to do like a little holidays buyer guide. Because I have a list of everything I'm purchasing.
the FrameLoss Holiday Buyer's Guide coming to you in September.
Yeah, I mean, that's where you got to do your shopping nowadays. So, next episode, we're going to do a buyer's guide, and we'll talk more about the just onslaught of titles that we will be coming across. But, yeah,
I'm
really excited for Wasteland 2. I just wish it was at a better time than when it is.
Yeah, I mean... I think I've made my opinions about how you buy video games well documented.
Yeah.
But I think it'll be good. I think people just need to buy it and play it. We'll see how long it takes that to happen.
Yeah.
Speaking of... I hate that I have to do speaking of for everything because I don't know any other like segues into anything. Wasteland's an old PC game. Other old PC games, Alone in the Dark and Haunted House, which both series are being rebooted by Atari. There's not a lot of details right now, but the title is called Alone in the Dark Illumination. There's a mailing list sign-up page, but that's about it. It's in development at a studio called Pure. Both of the games are expected to release by the end of 2014.
This year?
Yeah, and nothing's been said about it. Yeah,
and there's nothing. There's not even footage.
No, there's no platforms, so it would have to be PC. But I mean, that hasn't even been specifically
development for PC.
Oh, okay, all right. But there's no other platforms like Xbox One or anything like that. So
yeah,
PC's the only one. I don't know how they snuck this in, like, without anyone catching on. I don't know how it's going to be out by the end of the year, but
I'm calling pushback right now.
Yeah, I don't see them making... It's maybe one, but not
why
both.
Why would they not show anything if they...
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense.
They said quarter four 2014. I don't know if they know, but we're basically in quarter three.
Yeah. Quarter three is almost over.
Yeah. I don't know.
So,
man.
Yeah.
Never mind. I rethought it. I like the idea of all these horror games coming back, like with the Silent Hill news. I think there's a Resident Evil thing happening. I like the idea of it, but Alone in the Dark...
Is that Snowflake game?
Yeah, the Snowflake game. That's Until Dawn. They did release that.
Oh, okay.
Which is another reboot. I'm all for the idea of revamping these old horror games, because I feel like new horror games kind of suck, so at least give me something. Even if
yeah,
I played
exactly.
It. Alone in the Dark, I never really got into, but... It's something. I don't understand how it's
I've never been a huge Alone in the Dark guy. They scared me a lot when I was a kid, and that sort of...
You didn't like the movie with Christian Slater and Who's the actress in that? Tara Reid?
Christian Slater reminds me of Jack Nicholson, but worse.
Ooh.
That's rough. That's my
Christian Slater. That is a rough statement.
Yeah. Yeah. You're not wrong.
Reptar asks in the chat if we play console. I play console more than I play PC nowadays. I like both the new consoles. I just like some of the games that they release on console more. I don't know. I'm really liking a game that we'll talk about in a little bit that's only on console. And sitting right here, and I'm pretty pumped to talk about it because it's really fun. Came out of nowhere for me.
I played... I don't have them. I bum off of 2 inches. But I played Infamous. Infamous was awesome on the 360. Yeah, I mean, on the PS4.
Infamous was really good. I platinumed that like the first weekend I got it.
Everyone who knows me knows that I'm a huge Forza 5 fan. I've only played it for about maybe like 2 or 3 hours total, but that's my wheelhouse right there, realistic car games. So that's a home run for me every time. I used to be more of a console gamer. Now I'm more PC because I finally built a PC that can do it. But I do still have a soft spot for consoles.
Yeah. So with that,
Speaking of the few console games I do like.
Let's talk about NHL 15. So NHL recently announced that they are removing the EASHL League.
That's the EA Sports Hockey League?
Yep. It's a popular game mode, and it's been removed from this year's iteration. NHL 15 fans are none too happy with this change.
So for those of you, let me just give a quick rundown.
See, I've never played it, so...
Yeah, I'll give a quick rundown of like what it is specifically, because it's not a very intuitive name. How it works is you create like your character, you create your guy, you pick a position, center, right wing, left wing, goalie, defense, whatever, and you are on a team that's made up of other real people playing the game, and it's real teams of real people against real teams of real people. And that's their multiplayer. Well, it's not their only multiplayer, but that's like the main. That's how they do, like, create a pro multiplayer, and it works out really, really well. And it's a lot of fun. Most games, sports wise, don't have the, you know, you can't really do it in football. Can't really do it in baseball, basketball maybe, but like not really. Hockey's the only one where this like really works, and it works really well. So,
yeah, that's missing. And on top of that, online team play was also cut from the game as well, but they said that will roll out in an update later on. What's the difference between online team play and the other mode? Because they both sound the same now, that like, if you say them out loud.
I think online team play, you can like switch between the players and stuff. Okay. I don't do a ton of that.
Or is it just the same thing, just it's not a league? It's just...
Isn't the
league like you're actually playing like a season? Like
yeah, you have whole seasons of stuff. Again, I don't specifically know off the top of my head because I don't do the online team play. Okay. I do the EA Sports Hockey League, but I think the online team play is just you can like switch play, like if you like 3-on-3 and like people can move around, like who they're controlling, et cetera. I could be wrong.
So Sean, the producer at EA Sports, had this to say. As a franchise, we're 100% committed to the EA Sports Hockey League. While we can't deliver EASHL and NHL 15 on the Xbox One and PlayStation 4, we have huge plans for the mode in the future iterations of the game. We will be putting together a small EAS... That name sucks to say.
You got it. You just have to say EA Sports Hockey League. It's
EA
easier.
EA Sports Hockey League committee made up of you, the fans, to ensure that we deliver an experience that is bigger and better than anyone would ever imagine. When we first introduced this feature in NHL 09, we can now confirm that the following game modes will be available when you purchase NHL 15 on the PS4 and Xbox One on September 9th. The game modes are Play Now, Be a Pro, Be a GM, Online Versus, Hockey Ultimate Team, and NHL Moments Live. I only play Be a Pro, so my game's still there, so I'm happy.
Yeah, I mean, Be a Pro is probably the biggest game mode outside of EA Sports Hockey League.
It's Hockey RPG.
I would say that EA Sports Hockey League is, like, gotta be 2 or 3. And if it's not 2, then Hockey Ultimate Team is. But their Ultimate Team is, like, not that great compared to, like, FIFA and Madden.
Yeah.
Just so-so. NHL Moments Live, always fun, but it doesn't really make up for anything.
Yeah. I mean, I'm still going to buy it because Be a Pro is there, and that's all I care about. I had friends who wanted me to join their team until this announcement was made, and now some of them aren't even buying the game. So it is affecting people's purchases.
Yeah, I mean, it's an extremely popular... I don't think they understand how popular it is.
I understand the idea of, if it isn't done, don't release it. I'm 100% for that. But at the same time, why wasn't it done? Like, they didn't release a next-gen copy of the game last year. This is their first next-gen copy. Wouldn't you think they'd want to, like, jump in, guns blazing?
Yeah.
Like, why wasn't it finished? I know they can't delay the game because they have to hit the hockey season. That's the point of the game. That's what gets them their sales. So they can't delay the game, but it should have been done.
I just don't get... You've had over a year to do that, to work on this. I don't... And it's not... I don't know. It just doesn't make a lot of sense. You have the Be a Pro stuff. You have the online versus stuff. I don't understand where the disconnect is between those two modes that don't allow this to happen.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm still going to get it. I love the NHL RPG, so...
I will play every sports RPG. I like the Ultimate Team stuff. Usually I end up pre-ordering or getting the really dumb... EA Sports like early access thing, and that usually gives me like 25 weeks of a free pack a week in the Ultimate Team. Well, now they're doing just like EA Access.
Yeah, and I think EA Access you get 6 hours early, or you get 6 hours of playtime. Something announced with just 6 hours.
I don't know.
People weren't pumped about that either.
I don't know.
That's a different story.
But I know I used to get Ultimate Team stuff for being like a member of that.
Yeah.
I am not a member of that currently, so I don't think I'll be, and I don't think I will be joining it. So I probably care less about Ultimate Team now.
Yeah.
excuse me. Sorry to clear my throat. So, I don't know if you guys heard this about the Xbox One, but there's finally something you can do on it that isn't playing games. I know there's been a lot of people clamor for this.
All I do is play games on it, so this is news to me.
It's about time. It's about time.
Yeah.
This week, Microsoft rolled out a new update that includes Red X, which is the Reddit Xbox app. I don't really understand the value in this app. I know that was a really like paused out. That was like a Shatner sentence because I really had to like push those words out because I'm so confused. I don't get how browsing Reddit on your TV from your Xbox is an enjoyable experience. I can't even imagine being able to really like read Reddit.
I don't like looking at the internet on my TV.
Yeah, it never works well.
Even YouTube sucks on the TV.
Yeah, YouTube just doesn't know how to be on anything other than like the computer successfully. It's really weird.
Yeah.
I will say that one thing I like watching, one internet thing that like transitions really well is the WWE Network for only $9.99.
You had to get that in.
Yeah, that works out. That does a smooth transition.
Yeah.
In addition to Red X, there's an MTV app.
Why'd they call it Red X?
They really want to get that Final Fantasy VII demo.
Yeah.
That's who they're catering to. They also have an MTV app they're coming out with. They are making some changes to Twitch. I want to say there's like over 75 apps coming. 45 new entertainment experiences. That
Maybe they
announced
have
back in June.
New games coming.
Well, they announced this back in June. People don't buy consoles to play games, Kyle. Okay? I'm tired of this. If I wanted to play video games, I'd buy a Game Boy. back in June, they announced like 45 new entertainment experiences. I don't know how many of them are out now. It's basic stuff that's out everywhere else, like Epics and Crunchyroll and FX Now and MTV, or not MTV, MLG, NBA, NHL, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. I'm not going to read the whole list.
Yeah.
But just basic stuff. So I don't know why Reddit was somehow prioritized over the rest of this.
Well, Red X,
yeah. But it was. So I wonder if it's locked for only gold members. That's my question.
You know what I didn't... So they had a list of all the updates that were coming to Twitch. What I didn't see in that list was increase quality. Or like toggle quality. For some reason, anytime I watch Twitch on the Xbox One, it is just the worst quality possible. And I like just have to deal with it. Which I don't. I turn it off and I go watch it on my computer because I'm an adult.
I will say that I think I will say this for the Xbox One. It's like a console made for people with ADD. I really like the idea of being able to do two or three things while I'm playing a video game.
Yeah.
So it does have that going for it, but I don't think that this app is gonna be that great.
So moving on, let's talk about, I feel like this show, like just specifically this one, because we're not always super negative. This show is just like anger and hate.
Well, I mean, yeah, that's what fuels views. That's how we get hits.
Yeah, I mean, you're not wrong. So let's talk about Star Citizen.
Boo!
Star Citizen hit their $50 million milestone, and I still wonder if the game will even happen.
No, it won't.
So, over the last few days, Star Citizen hit the new milestone, the $50 million funded tier. I'll tip my hat to them, but then I'll put it back on and look them square in the eye and ask them if that's even remotely enough to finish the game that they are claiming that they're making. I don't know a ton about game development, but I do know that a little game called Grand Theft Auto 5 came out, and their budget, not including marketing, was listed as $250 million. That game is pittance in comparison to the scale this game is. And $50 million is not a lot when making a game of that size, I think. I could be wrong. I could be talking out my ass completely, but I feel like I'm close.
Yeah, I can't see them finishing it with $50 million. I mean, is $50 million a lot of money? On a personal level, yes. Like, I would love $50 million bucks. But I can't see doing a video game of this magnitude with $50 million. That just seems not feasible in any way.
And don't get me wrong. I want this game to happen. I own it. Like, I have the not the Kickstarter, but the $40 entry level purchase into the game. So, like, I do own a copy of it when it's actually available. But all they Never. Do is just put out new trailers and, like, bigger ships that you can spend, like, $5,000 on.
Yeah, people love it.
It's just a bunch of fanfare and, like, ships. And, like, they had a new trailer for the new hangar. It's like, okay, another place I can just walk around.
Yeah, exactly. Bye, Reptar. Say bye to Reptar, Kyle. Bye, Reptar.
Bye, Reptar.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know where. I'm very into, like, I think being excited for something's good. I think supporting things are good. I think being optimistic is good. I don't have any faith in. I don't got it. It doesn't. There's nothing that's been shown that this game is coming. There's just the same stuff over and over, and there's more videos, and there's more ships to walk around in, but that's the same stuff.
Yeah, I'm really just tired of waiting for this game. I feel like I paid for this.
This maybe, game's years ago.
Yeah, like a year and a half ago, I bought this.
This game's so it'll be amazing if it ever comes out, but I don't know how.
I don't know either.
Okay,
He speaks a big game.
Yeah.
Is all I'm saying.
Prove me wrong. I want to be proven wrong. I would love to get him on FrameLoss and talk to him about the game. And
yeah,
just talk to him. And I have all these questions that they get pushed to the side by, not my questions specifically, but all the questions in general don't get addressed. They have a dev blog every week, but it doesn't really cover a lot. So I would love to just talk to this guy and be like, look, like, what's the deal here? What's your plan?
Yeah. I don't know. I want Star Citizen to be good, but I don't see $50 million as a giant milestone in, like, oh my god, like, we're here.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, you can buy, like, you could pay for a little bit more development and make a new trailer, I guess.
Like, how much... it's, you know, people cost money, things cost money, there's bills to pay, there's salaries, there's monthly fees. $50 million is not a large amount in the grand scheme of, like, video game design.
Yeah.
So... But I think you have a secret game for us that we'll probably be more positive about.
Yeah. So I bought a game this past week. I'm going to show it. It's called Akiba's Trip, Undead and Undressed. Now, you're probably saying to yourself, 2 inches, that sounds like a really dirty, Japanese, just silly game that has no merit or no fluff, like, or just all fluff. People just think that this game is just a waste and to throw it away.
And they're right.
I did too, until I started playing it. So, Akiba Strip, Undead and Undressed, is a game where you are abducted. Well, you apply for a job, and in your interview, you wake up on a table and realize that you've been tricked into signing a contract, and they are going to turn you into a monster to steal people's life essence. How do you steal people's life essence? You basically just walk up to them and start draining them. Like, the monsters are really, like, not interesting. What is interesting is you get broken out of this place by a mysterious female, and she tells you you're going to help fight these evil people that captured you. How do you fight them? Well, you're basically vampires. You're called Synthisters. And you can't be out in the sun too long. So how do you fight the other Synthisters? You rip their clothes off.
The worst!
You basically run around, you'll get into a brawl, and you're basically trying to grab at their articles of clothing. You have to go for the head, the chest, and the pants. And you struggle, and you just rip their clothes off, and then they explode into, like, a puff.
Sounds like...
You can chain... If you weaken articles of clothing for, like, a big group, you can then chain strip everyone in the area.
Oh my god.
Massive strip combo. There's tons of items and customization in the game. It's actually a pretty deep RPG.
We build up 19 episodes of goodwill with our fans, and then you come out with this.
No. I'm telling you right now, don't judge a book by its cover. Judge it by its soul. And its soul is beautiful. This game is pure, just silly fun.
You should stream it.
You won't feel like most of the people I've been fighting are dudes, so you're just ripping off dudes' clothes. So you don't even feel that perverted half the time.
God, this game sounds awful.
Look at the back of the box. Fend off hordes of vampires the only way you know how. By stripping them so they melt in the sun. Over 450 clothing items and 80 makeshift weapons available. I'm going to try to beat that by next show so I can review it. I'm not promising anything because it seems like a really long game, but I'm impressed that I didn't just play this for an hour and go, well, that was a waste.
Kyle will be streaming this live for people to watch while he does this.
I'm definitely excited to play this game because I've been having a blast with it, and I'm only a couple hours in.
I might try it after you finish. I might, maybe.
Dude, it's super fun. It looks
if my girlfriend lets me.
On the outside, it looks like a dirty. I don't want people knowing I have this, but once you get into it, it's really good, and there's a lot of fun stuff going on.
That I want to say, like, that's the weirdest game that you've brought home, but I don't even think it is.
Yeah.
I think that's pretty, like...
Yeah, I don't think... I don't think it is, because it's not that weird.
Yeah.
It's kind of weird, I guess.
It's pretty weird. Let's not sugarcoat it. It's pretty weird. But again, I don't think it's the weirdest one you've...
So, Akiba's Strip. Undead and Undressed. Get hyped for FrameLoss.
Didn't you buy another?
No, I canceled that one.
Oh, okay.
The Senran Kanguru?
No, not the one from last week that I was embarrassed to even be associated with.
Yeah.
I thought you brought another one home with the vampire game that was...
Danganronpa for the Vita.
Yeah, what is that?
That's a game where you're in a school and it's like a murder mystery.
Oh, yeah. That game actually sounds really good. Tell everyone about that game.
So Danganronpa, I haven't played it. That one's for my girlfriend, but I'm probably going to try it. Danganronpa is a game where you wake up in a school. You're told the only way you're allowed to leave is if you can murder someone without anyone else finding out. You then find a body. You go to trial. You try and figure out who killed them. If you can't figure out who killed them, that person gets to leave the school and everyone else is killed. If you figure it out, that person gets killed. And then you basically return to your quarters and you have to continue to try and commit a murder so you can leave. There's a ton of mini games. Like, it's a really just interesting game.
I think it's super weird.
Bye, Pondo.
Bye, Pondo. I think it sounds really weird, but in a cool way. I will definitely be trying this game.
Yeah, and that's for the Vita.
I just read this real quick. We have some, a little bit of time at the end of the show, which is not our usual MO. But I can talk about this fan-made Shenmue HD remaster. That's happening.
I saw that.
And it looks gorgeous. I can't wait to play this. I don't know how I'll play it. I don't know if I will ever get to play it. I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen with it, but I want to play it so bad. Shenmue might be, like, if I realistically had to sit down and think about favorite games, might be my favorite game of all time. Definitely in my top five. I love Shenmue. Is probably the first RPG I played that I was like, oh yeah, I really like these kind of games after all.
That's like,
I played Final Fantasy VIII. That was okay. I played Final Fantasy IX. I liked it. I played Shenmue and I was like, this game rules. I was so hyped for Shenmue 2 when it came out. I love Shenmue 2. It was everything. It probably burst.
I wasn't huge on Shenmue 2.
I mean, I was huge on Shenmue 2 just because of Shenmue 1.
Just because it continued the story?
Yeah, exactly.
You know what would be cool is if they didn't do a remake, but they finished the fucking story.
Well, Sega isn't doing this remake.
Right.
That's,
I mean, fans
just
can write
guy.
Their own ending.
I don't want that.
Would you rather have a never end?
Yes. Then, like, 20 different fan-made Shenmue ending ones? Barf.
No, they're just making official...
Yeah. Just make an official unofficial ending.
No, I
would prefer Shenmue 3 to be like a real thing. If that can't happen, I don't want it. I will play this remaster if it happens. Hell, I will probably figure out a way to play Shenmue 1 again now that that's happened. I'm making a lot of streaming promises, but we'll stream that one too.
I don't know what you have to do to go out of your way, because I have it. And I have a Dreamcast.
Well, I gotta stream it, so I gotta hook up that thing, I guess.
Yeah.
I didn't know you had it. Do you have a VMU that works?
Yeah.
How? How do you have a VMU?
I have three, I think.
Okay, that's really good news for me. I'm gonna get on that right away. Sega also announced that their like Dreamcast collection that exists on Steam, they're adding achievements to it, like all the games. Like, so Sonic Adventure DX is one. Crazy Taxi, I think, is up there. There's a lot of, like, Dreamcast games up on Steam. And they're adding achievements to them all, which is awesome.
That's pretty cool.
I love achievements.
I won't play it, but...
Yeah, whatever, Kyle.
The show's about to end. I want to talk about the next episode. It is our 20th episode, because we're awesome.
The big 2-0.
Yep. So I feel like we should do the holiday buyer's guide, because in like 2 weeks,
dude, it's September.
I know, but in like 2 weeks, the floodgates are just going to go.
Right. But it's not the holidays.
There's a holiday coming up.
I refuse to do a Labor Day holiday show.
I mean, there's multiple holidays coming. Holidays Buyer's Guide, next show. You don't even have to do anything. I have it all written down.
I don't understand, like, why we wouldn't just be like, we're a video game talk show. Like, we can just talk about these new games coming out without any need for pretense.
I mean, we can, but we can call it the Holidays Buyer's Guide. Just
all right, yeah, F it. FrameLoss Holiday Special, next week.
I'm going to try my hardest to get a review for... Akiba's trip going?
No. You're not going to try your hardest. We're going to have a review of the game.
I'm not promising shit because I'm playing WoW right now.
This is... We'll talk off the air about this, young man. We'll take the. I'll turn this show around.
Yeah. Where did we get that, like, black frame loss thing in the chat? I don't even know how to make that.
What black frame loss thing?
I don't know. On my screen, there's like a. It's like frame loss with like a black border around it.
What? That's racist.
Yeah.
I just noticed.
I've noticed it a couple times, and I'm like,
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay,
so.
Maybe it's just me. Maybe it's because someone mentioned frame loss, so I see it.
No, so I no.
I don't know. Fraber Day weekend.
Yeah, I like that a lot.
Yeah. Get hyped for the next episode. Folks, we are frame
Wait,
loss.
Wait, whoa, 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 whoa,
whoa. Oh, oh, oh.
Whoa.
Shh. CJ's talking.
As you guys 2 weeks ago saw our first like rolling out of this segment, thanks to viewer Macho Man Randy Cleavage, we have a new Games You Should Play, where we highlight one of our favorite games that like might have gotten missed, might have gotten swept under the rug, something like that. These won't be new games. These won't be necessarily games that everyone loves, but they're games that Kyle or I love.
This week it's Akiba's Trip.
False. No, not true. God damn it. This week, my game is Advance Wars for the Game Boy Advance. I think it got a lot of press at the time. And people were like, oh, this game's amazing. And I think people really like forgotten about it. It is probably the only tactic RPG that I like.
But you were pumped for Wasteland.
Tactic RPG.
Wasteland's got to be tactics.
No. No. Fallout Tactics is tactics. Mm. Anyway. I mean, that's another one I like, so.
Okay.
There's very few. I've played a lot of tactic RPGs. I don't really love most of them. Even ones like the Marvel one that exists is just not really my cup. But I do like Advance Wars. The first one obviously doesn't have a lot of the polish that the later ones do. Dual Strike was the DS. There was Advance Wars 2 on the Game Boy Advance also. But the Advance Wars 1 is really, that's the purest version of it. That's what they started from. It has it's my favorite one. It might not be the best one, but it's my favorite. So I think that if you guys can dig out your Game Boy Advance, if you can find a copy of this for like $5 somewhere, do what you gotta do. I don't judge. But definitely, if you haven't played it, give it a shot. If you have played it, maybe go give it a look again. Remind yourself why you loved it in the first place. So yeah, that's my game of the week. That's my game you should play.
Okay. I'll accept that. You said, but yeah, I was going to be mad about it.
Yeah, well, it was a Game Boy Advance game, so I figured you were just going to be pissed.
No. I don't judge.
That's not true.
No, I judge everything.
Judging is just, that's all we do.
Folks, I'm an asshole.
That's how 2 Inches and I have bonded, is by the fact that we both are huge assholes.
Well, that's our show.
That's Frame Loss.
Folks, we're here every Wednesday at 8 p.m. EST.
8 p.m. Eastern every Wednesday.
I'm your host, 2 Inches. With me is CJ. Pew. One day I'm going to be like, this is how I point to CJ. And I'm going to do it right every time. One day.
Oh, my God. Never.
But at the same time, I know where to point to for you to like subscribe and do all that stuff. That's down there.
Rate, join review, our channel, rate, subscribe.
Do all the fun stuff. We're on Facebook. We have a Twitter.
Someday we'll have a website.
I update once every month.
once every week, Wednesday at 7:30, we update.
No, the Twitter's not updated.
Oh, the Twitter, Christ, yeah. Someday we'll have a website. You can check that out then. We're never going to have Sidetracked, but this week we will.
No, Sidetracked will happen eventually.
This week. We promise it every week, but this week it's happening. Well, I guess next week it's happening. But
yeah, get hyped for that.
This frame loss week, which goes from a Wednesday to Wednesday.
Yeah.
Get hype. Get hype, stay hype.
Holiday Buyer's Guide. Folks, we're out. Thank you for watching.
Good night, good game.
The video crashed!
No!